Welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. My name is Lydia, and today's video is going to be about how to overcome your fear of failure. I'm an Enneagram 3, which if you don't know what that is the achiever, and their main fear is failing, which kind of makes it difficult to put my all into anything because then I'll have to tell people that I put my all into it and still it wasn't enough if I happen to fail. Failing is just not fun in general. But what if we could change our mindset and look at it in a different way and think of it as a learning experience instead of us failing? First, you have to think of what failing is for you personally. How do you define failing? Is it if you can't accomplish what you said you were going to accomplish? What even is failing? I have some tips I wrote down of what you can do to overcome your fear of failing. How to deal with failure, pretty much. Let's just get right on into the tips of how to deal with failure. All right, tip number one. First of all, you have to recognize your emotions that like you might be very disappointed in yourself. It's okay to be disappointed, but not when you take it to the extreme. If you acknowledge it, it's easier to accept it and get over it than if you constantly push your emotions aside because they will resurface eventually. Trust me, I have done that so many times where I push my emotions down, don't let myself even think about them. I try to distract myself with anything possible. Seeing if my friends want to hang out, watching a movie, reading a book. Just try to do so much to try to distract yourself from dealing with your emotions because it's painful and difficult to deal with your emotions. Trust me, if you actually just accept the emotions that you're feeling as you feel them, then it is so much easier to get over them and to move on with life because that's really just what you gotta do. Second tip is to not take it personally. Like, don't put your identity into succeeding or accomplishing things. Like, yes, it is so great when you can accomplish things. It is amazing, but do not put your worth in that. Instead of focusing on the fact that you didn't achieve that unrealistic goal you had set for yourself, or even if it was realistic, you just didn't get there by the time, there's nothing you can do about it now. You just have to keep moving forward and try harder next time. Like, that's really all you can do, so you just have to let it go. Tip number three, don't worry about what anyone else thinks, because at the end of the day, you shouldn't be trying to make other people happy. You should be trying to make yourself happy, but also to make God happy and to do what he wants you to do in life. So don't waste your time trying to please other people, because there's no way to please everyone. There's always going to be someone who's disappointed in you or upset with you. Like, there's no way to please everyone. Just make sure you're doing the right thing and you did your best. Another thing that you just got to do is take the right amount of responsibility. Let's say that at work there was a team project and you took on more than you could handle and you kind of knew that, but you did it anyway because you were trying to impress people and you ended up not getting all of it done. Do not blame it on your team or come up with excuses, because the reality of it is you should have known that you couldn't handle all that and you needed their help. Take the right amount of responsibility, but also don't overdo it, because we all make mistakes. We're all human. When you make a mistake, all you can do is look forward, try your best next time. That's just one example. There's so many other things with failing. Another thing is you can use failure as a way to improve. Once you fail, then you know that's not how you're gonna do it next time. You'll know how to handle it at least a little bit better. Some people just think of themselves as a failure. Factors that can play into this, like feeling like you're a failure mindset, are like a sense of hopelessness, anxiety, depression, feelings of helplessness, lack of supportive relationships, low self-esteem, making comparisons with others, negative self-talk, unrealistic expectations. So all of that can lead to this bummed out feeling where you just feel like you can't do anything and it sucks, but you have to pick yourself up and get back up and try again, because if you don't try again, there's absolutely no way that you're going to succeed. And remember, you're not alone, because we all make mistakes. Everyone has those days where they really feel like they just can't do anything right. Everyone's fighting their own battle. Whether we talk to each other about it or not, everyone has their struggles. As soon as you start feeling like this, write down a list of things that you know will make you feel better. Like, it could be anything, like calling a friend, taking a bubble bath, going for a walk, cuddling your pets, practice deep breathing, journaling. Basically, there's so many things. Having a dance party in your room alone. Whatever makes you feel alive and happy. Make a list of those things to do as soon as you start feeling. Do as soon as you start feeling any of those ways. You have to acknowledge your irrational beliefs about failure. We blow things way out of proportion in our minds, and when a situation actually comes around where we happen to fail, it's not like everything blows up in our face. The friends who actually care about you won't care if you made a mistake. Like, they will forgive you and accept the fact that you're human just like they are, and we all make mistakes. You have to develop realistic thoughts about failure. Like, instead of thinking about how everything's gonna blow up in your face, everyone's gonna hate you, all of that, that you think comes with failing. Instead think, failure is a sign that I'm challenging myself to do something difficult. I can handle failure. I can learn from my failures. Like, it is okay to fail. Whenever you fail in any area of your life, ask yourself, what can I learn from this? Make a list of things, and then it suddenly becomes okay that you failed, because you're like, look at all the positive things that happened from it. I learned so much. Instead of just focusing on the fact that you failed. The last step is to create a plan for moving forward. What are you gonna do to get over this? Next time you fail, are you going to go right back into that cycle of thinking all those negative things about it? Or are you gonna hold on to what you just learned and keep that with you and grow and keep climbing upward on the growth scale of life? I don't even know what that is, but I think you guys know what I mean though, right? The more you face your fear of failure, the more it becomes okay to fail. Gradually, it'll go away and you'll be okay with failing. So yeah, I hope that some of these tips helped you, or you just got something out of this video. Thank you for watching. Please give this video a like and comment down below what video I should do next. And subscribe if you want to see more content from me. I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Peace out, my peeps.